Hi students, in this lesson we are going to learn about a joint stock company. So last three lesson we studied some business, so sole trader business, Hindu and divided family business and partnership firm. So all three have some limitation, but joint stock company overcome that limitation. Okay, so in the modern world and advancement of in science and technology, so we need large amount of capital investment and high sophisticated managerial skills for running a large scale industry. But partnership would have some limitation. We can introduce a small number of capital only, because only 20% are available in the maximum available 20 only in the partnership, and managerial ability only that 20 members can manage the business, and order some risk also. There is unlimited liability. So unlimited liability means, so the business asset not enough to repay the loan, their own assets also used to for repayment of loan. So has been found unsuitable of running a large scale industry in modern time. So sole proprietor also unlimited liability, and Hindu undivided family also. Karta is a unlimited liability, and partnership is a some unlimited liability. So it's not suitable for running a large scale of industry in modern time. So therefore we introduce a joint stock company in India Act 2013. The Company Act 2013. In nearly we have Company Act, that is in 1956, and after that we made some changes, and we have to introduce, came to force on 12th September 2013. Okay, so this act can be divided 29 chapters and 470 section, 29 chapters and 470 section. And what are the changes they made? They have made the membership 50 to 200. So for earlier, so in the joint stock company a maximum member is a 50, now it will be changed 200. So yeah, another one new class company of 1% company. So even 1% also made a company, it included this act in the private limited company. And definition: a company is an association of many person who contribute money or money worth yet to a common stock and employ it in some trade or business, and who share the profit and losses as the case may be arising the firm. Okay, so a company is an association of many person who contribute money or money worth to a common stock. And what about stock? We are going to discuss later. I will tell what is a common stock, and apply it in some trade or business, and who share the profit and losses as the case arising the firm. James Stevenson. And a company is the artificial person. So already we know human person and artificial person. So human create a artificial person, that is a joint stock company. A company is the artificial person created by law, having a separate entity with a perpetual succession and a common seal. Okay, so perpetual succession means continuity, it will be work. And a common seal means it has some common seal. Okay, and I will explain what is a common seal next topic. Okay, this is a definition, and now we are going to see characteristics of joint stock company. So these are the points they given. First one, separate legal entity, limited liability, perpetual succession, separate property, transferability of shares, common seal, capacity to sue and being sued, separate management, one share, one vote. So what is separate legal entity? Under incorporation, a company becomes a separate legal entity as compared to its members. The company is distinct and different from its members. Okay, so members and company. So both are different. It have a legal entity, it has a name, it has a own name, it has a seal, It has asset and liability and separate distinct from those of its members. Okay, so all the asset of the company, it will be by the name of the company only. So all the liability, it will be come to company name only. And it has separate name and it has a seal, own seal. And so it is capable owing property, incurred debt and borrowing money, employing people, have a bank account, entering into contract and suing and being sued separately, suings. So we can put a legal action. So that is a suing and being sued separately. And in short, it is considered as an artificial person created by law. Okay. Separate legal entity means, so it's the human man create a artificial man by a law. Okay. By a law, the human create a artificial man. That's a joint stock company. And it has a own seal and it has a own name. And in the name of the company, we can buy asset and we can borrow a loan. And we have it have own bank account and it into contract with the name of the company only and suing and being sued separately. So it considered as a artificial person created by law. That is a separate legal entity. It is different from its member. So members different from company. That is a separate legal entity. Limited liability. The liability of the members of the company is limited to contribution to the asset of the company up to the face value of the shares held by him. So only contribute to the asset of the company up to the face value of share held by him. A member is liable to pay only the uncalled money due to on shares held by him. If the asset of the company are not sufficient to pay liability, the personal properties of the shareholder are not held responsible. Okay, so only the company assent to repay the loan, the personal property of the members or shareholder, it's not affected. That is an unlimited liability. Only they have to pay the remaining called money, uncalled money. Okay, so what is the uncalled money? I explained here. So all the shares, for example, particular share rupees, 10 rupees. Okay. So from the shareholder, they collect like this only 2 rupees, 3 rupees, 2 rupees and 3 rupees. Okay. First, they collected application form, 2 rupees and allotment. This is the allotment. Maybe in not knowing that, kindly understand. So this is a application. This is a application. Okay. And this is a first call. This is a first call and final call. Final call or second call. So in this way only they collected amount from the shareholder. Okay. So actually joint stock company means so the members can collect the amount from the public. It's called a shareholders. From the shareholder, they can collect a money. Okay. So maybe the share rupees, the 10 rupees means they have to collect like this way. 2 rupees for application, 3 rupees for allotment and 2 rupees for first call and 3 rupees for final call. Okay. Suppose they already one shareholder pay 5 rupees. The shareholder pay 5 rupees. So remaining 5 rupees we didn't call. That is a uncalled money. Okay, we didn't call. So before that they have lost their business. Okay, so they have to repay the loan. The personal property of the shareholder, it's not affected. Only they are repay this 5 rupees only. Only they have to repay this 5 rupees only. Okay, so this is a limited liability. So a member is liable to pay only the uncalled money due to the share held by him. Their personal property, the personal property of the shareholder are not held responsible. So that is a limited liability. And perpetual succession. Perpetual succession. So a company does not cease to exist unless it is a specifically wanted or the task for which it was formed, it has been completed. So members of the company may keep on changing from time to time to time. That does not affect life of the company. A company is created by law and it can be wind up only through the legal process. Okay, so here what they mentioned, a company does not cease to exist unless specifically wanted or task for which it was formed has been completed. Membership of the company may keep on changing from time to time. Okay, so for example, A limited company, now 50 members are there. 50 members are there. Okay, so after that, if they want to sell their shares to another person, so 20 members sell their property, sell their shares to another 20. Okay, so now they are changed. The company members are changed. Okay, because they sell their shares to another person. So now members are changed. Okay, but it not affect the business. It's not affect the company. So membership can be changed time to time, but it not affect the company. So a company created by law and it can be wind up only through the legal process. So they are created by the law. If they want to wind up through the legal process only, they can wind up. So that is their perpetual succession. It will be continued to work. Okay. But compare other business, just to compare the other business, if they have to, if they have this, they can wind up. Separate property. A company is their distinct legal entity. A member cannot claim to owner of the company property during the existence of the company. Okay. So already I told you, a company have own asset seal and its own name. Okay, so it has own property. A company has its own property. A member cannot claim to ownership of the company property. So they are the member of the business only. They cannot claim the particular property. So that is a separate property. So that is a company property. The member cannot claim it. And capacity to sue and being sued. Sue abdina valakku porradu alladhu company mela valakku porradu. Being sued. A company can sue or be sued in its own name as distinct from its members. Transferability of SAS. SAS in a company are freely transferable. For example, A limited company SAS in with me 500 SAS. I have a 500 share, that is a limited company. Okay, so now I am the shareholder of the A limited company. Now I want to money, so for that I sell my 200 share to another person. Okay, so my membership change to another person immediately, freely we can change the company shares to another person. That is a transferability of shares. So whenever I need, I can sell my SAS. So even though I can purchase the SAS from others also. So that is a freely transferable. So when a member transfer his SAS to another person, the transferee step into the source of the transfer and acquire all the right of the transfer is respect to those rights. So if I sell those SAS to other person, so my rights also change to that another person. So there are a restriction in the transferability of shares in case of the private company. So only the private company, some restriction are there to share the shares to others. Okay, that is a transferability of shares. And common seal, the definition also we studied. A company have a separate seal. Our school have separate seal. So without a seal, anybody sign mean it's not valid. Okay, if you get a sign from the principal, but you not get the sign mean it's not valid. Okay, the seal have some power. So like company also have separate seal. So a company is an artificial person and does not have physical presence. Okay. So thus it is act through in the board of director for carrying out its activities and entering into various agreement. If they are made any agreement to others company or the other business, so such contract must be under the seal of the company. Okay. So they should be signed by the members, and also they should be sealed. Yeah, without a seal, any contract, it's not valid. So the common seal is official signature of the company. So that common seal, that is a signature of the company. The name of the company must be engraved in the common seal. So engraved means they have to write in the seal their company name. Okay. Did you notice our school name? In school common seal, so it was printed a school name. A school, it's not a company. For example, I told you, so in the seal must be engraved the common seal. The name of the company must be engraved on the common seal. So any document not bearing the seal of the company may not be accepted by authentic and it may not have any legal force. So without a seal, any sign it is there, it is not valid. So we have not used that for legal force also. That is a common seal. So a company is an artificial person. It does not have any physical presence. It managed by the board of directors. It has a common seal. So any agreement, any contract, we have to do with the seal only. This is a common seal. And separate management. A company is administrator and managed by its managerial person, and that is their board of directors. Okay. So maybe that company have 1,000 members. So all the one, they cannot participate in the business. Okay. So board of directors selected by the members, maybe 10 board of directors, they be run the business. Okay. That is a separate management. So by this managerial personal, that is your board of directors, the shareholders are simply the holder of the shares in the company and need not necessary manager of the company. Okay. So they are the shareholder of the company. They are member of the company, but they no need to manage the company. Only board directors are manage the companies. So that is a separate management. And one share, one voter. It's very interesting. So one company share 1,000 shares. Okay. So in my hand, I have 700. Okay, so others have different sizes. So in my hand, totally I have 700 shares. So I have 700 voting capacities. Okay, so he has 10 votes in the company. Okay, so if a person 10 shares, he has 10 votes in the company. The same way, I have 700 shares means I have a 700 voting capacity of the particular company. So if you want to select any board members, so maybe I am the board directors because I have a power, voting power. I only select a majority of the people. So this is the direct distinctions voting principle of the corporate society. One member, one voter principle applies. That is irrespective of the member of the circle, one member has only one vote. Okay. And advantages of the joint stock company. So one large capital. Okay. So we can collect it from the peoples. So they can invest their money to the business. So we can collect a large number of the amount. So a company can secure large capital compared to the sole trader or partnership. So large amount of capital necessary for conduct the business large scale. For example, Reliance has invested more than 25,000 crores in the telecom ventures. So raising such a huge amount fund would be utter impossible to sole traders or partnership. In the sole trader, because they cannot invest this much amount. Even partnership also, it's not possible. Only it's possible through the joint stock company. And limited liability. So many times we discussed. So their personal assets, they're not used for the business loan, that is a limited liability. The liability of shareholders is limited in the case of the company limited by guarantee. His liability restricted to the amount that has guaranteed to contribute even of winding up the company. Where maybe the company going to close also, it's not affect their personal asset. And examples of limited liability. Syam is a shareholder of the company holding 500 shares. Syam, one person is there. He holds totally 500 shares in his hand. So 10 each on which he has already 7 per share. Okay. So per share rupees, 10 rupees. Okay. So 500 share, it's with him. So 500 into 10, actually 5,000. Totally, he purchases share amount 5,000. Okay. He already paid 7 per share. So per share, he already paid 7 rupees. So 500 into 7. 5 sevens are 35,000 already he paid. So remaining this 1,500 he didn't pay. In the event of losses or company failed to repay the debt, Syam is liable to pay only this 1,500 amount only. Okay. Okay, because he didn't pay this 3 rupees per share, he didn't pay that amount alone. He is payable to particular company, but other asset they not affected. That is a limited liability. Transferability of shares. It's also already we discussed in the characteristics of joint stock company. He can easily transfer to other person. So transaction of shares between the two individual is easy. So it's not affect the business. So there is liquidity of investment. So any shareholder can easily convert his share into money by selling the shares. Okay. For example, in my hand, 500 shares of A limited company. If I need money, so directly I can sell my shares and easily I can convert to a money. Okay. So that is a transferability of shares. And perpetual succession. So it's already discussed in the characteristics. Same thing. So it will continuous expenses of the business. Members may be change, new member it will come, or old members they can exchange their SAS to other person, but it not affect the company. The company continue to work with the other members. So ensues continuity it operation, and the company can undertaking long-term investment. That is a perpetual succession. Promotion of saving and investment habit. Okay, so it encourages the people to invest their money and save their money. Okay, and the joint stock company system encourages the people to save. Even a small amount can be used for the purchase of shares. A person can buy one share of the company. So one company need 1 lakh rupees. 1 lakh rupees. Okay, so they have to sell 1,000 shares and they have to sell 10 rupees per shares. Okay, so they can collect 1 lakh rupees. They can collect from the people 1 lakh rupees. Okay, so the shareholder can buy only 1 shares. They can buy. Okay, they can interest, they can buy 200 shares, 100 shares, 50 shares, any number of shares they can buy. Okay, because they have to pay only 10 rupees for 1 shares. Okay, so that is small amount of can invest to the joint stock company. It encourages their saving and investment habit. Risk bearing capacity. The loss of the company is distributed over a large number of shareholders. So each shareholder bear a very little amount of the loss. Okay, hence the company form an organization as risk bearing capacity. Okay, so for example, one company have a 1,000 shareholders. Okay, so one time the company lost 10,000 rupees okay, the company lost 10,000 rupees in the particular business. Okay, so this 10,000 amount loss, it will be divided to 1,000 shareholder. Okay, so all these 1,000 share that particular loss also of the business. Okay, so they have to share this loss amount. So they can divide it like this. So only they can bear this 10 rupees amount only for the loss. Okay, so the large amount, large number of shareholder, they have to share the losses. So each shareholder bear very little amount of the loss. So hence the company form of organization has risk bearing capacity and economic of large scale operation. A joint stock company can undertake business on large scale. As a result, it can derive all advantages of large scale production. For example, Hero Motor Corp Limited 2015, the world largest seller of two-wheelers, manufactured motorbike on a large scale and is able to enjoy cost efficiency. Okay. So a joint stock company can undertake a business in a large scale. Other business, they cannot enlarge their business. Okay, as a result, it can derive all advantages of the large scale production. And economic development. Joint stock company system has been responsible for the rapid growth of industry and trade in many countries. Since joint stock company have large financial resources, they are able to undertake large scale production. They can produce large number of product and they can satisfy the need of more number of consumers and create a large scale employment opportunity to the employees, to the people, and promote balanced regional development and contribute sustainability to the government by way of the tax. Okay, so the particular company, they can produce a large number of the product, they can satisfy the people, and they can create a larger employment opportunity to the people, and they have to balance the regional development and contribute the tax amount. So the joint stock company, they have to pay large number of amount to the taxes. So it will be used to the economic development. And disadvantages of the joint stock company: costly and difficult to form. So number of legal formality must be observed in the formation of the company. To observe the legal formality, promoters have spent much time and money also. Okay, so sole proprietorship, they no need to concern with anyone, they can start the business. Hindu under family, two or family, they can join it, they can start the business without legal formality. In the partnership, they no need to register. If they are willing, they can register. Otherwise, they no need to follow the any rules and regulation. In here, they are going to collect amount from the people. So from the shareholder, they are the shareholders. Okay. So here we have large of formality. To observe the legal formality, promoters have spent much time and money. So for the formation, we have to follow large number of formality. So that is a costly and difficult to form. Scope for dishonest and unscrupulous management. The director manage the company with the help of paid officers. Okay. So already told, you know, board members only manage the business. Okay, they are the board directors. So directors manage the company with the help of the paid officer. So that means they appointed some officer to manage that. So for that, they are giving some salary to them. So they are the manage the business. If the director are dishonest, so the particular person is dishonest, means they may be make a personal gain at the expenses of the company. So they may be misuse their power and position. So this is a scope for dishonest and unscrupulous management. Management oligarchy. A few rich persons may secure control over the affairs of the company. Thus, the management's joint stock company might become oligarchs in characters. So that means small group of people having control. And speculation. A few individuals may corner the shares to gain control over the company. So same thing. So the few individuals may corner the shares. They have to purchase more number of the shares and they have to get the gain to that over the company. That is a speculation. And lack of interest. The officer of the company do not have incentive to work hard. They are not usually inclined to task risk. That is a lack in attitude. Okay, so maybe the board members appointed the officials, they do not have incentive to work. So for the work, they only should get the salary or remuneration. It's not enough to them. So maybe it will be lack of interest. It is there. And lack of good labor relations. In sole trading business, personal supervision is possible. It's already we discussed in the direct relationship with the, in characteristics already we studied, direct relationship with the customers. Sole proprietor, they can contact with the customers directly. So, but here it's not possible. Okay. But in the company firm organization, there is a lack of personal contact between the owners and workers. As a result, there is a scope for more industrial dispute in a company firm of organization. And high taxation. So joint stock companies have to pay tax at a higher rate compared to other firm of the organization. Here taxation is high rate because they are collected from the people and they are doing a large number of business. The taxation also will be high. Okay, so it will decrease the profit. So that is a high taxation. So these are the disadvantages of the joint stock company. I hope and what is understood, what is the joint stock company. So remaining things we will discuss on the next video. Thank you, students.